points on the list. Leaving it here, but still get a spread. Started with a little, but still reinvesting. Fear how I feel, then you feel less blessed. I just want the lesson, I just want protection. I'm up and I'm down, but the sound like progression. Farmer never plans if he waits for perfection. Fingers to the down.
Yeah. All right, ladies and gentlemen, I got your watch list coming in on May 10th, 2021, and the stock market is getting inflation. And I got three stacks that I'm looking at coming in tomorrow. But if you thought the inflation talks were going away anytime soon, they are not. We are getting a lot of economic data this week. Earnings are wrapping up, so the market is going to trade a little bit different, but a lot of economic data, inflation, everything from last week, and even policy, that is going to come up a lot this week. So we got a lot to talk about. I want to go over what happened in the market last week, what we're looking at this week, the plays that we made, and then the plays that we're looking at coming into tomorrow. But let us not delay. You guys know what you need to do. Drop your thumbs up on the video. Make sure you're subscribed. And if you don't know, we are live Monday through Friday, 30 minutes for open. It's the first link in the description, and it is pinned in the comments. We better see you there in the morning. It's free 99. It costs you nothing to join. YouTube.com/thestockmarket. You can post the plays, see the plays, watch the watch list come to life. And yes, if your mama raised you well, then we can clearly tell, baby. Shout out to all the moms out there. And don't ever forget the power of moms long term, baby. We love all of you guys. Say you love you to your mom, okay? That's some cults. And the most important thing you need to do, post or watch below. Let us know what you're looking at. Got any plays, comments, remixes, anything. Post them below and source that info. Shout out to Chad, baby. And please do not forget, today is Sunday, tomorrow is Monday, and we need your help. This is the random account generator. We started this with $500 about a year and a half ago. We asked that you post a random option trade in the comments below. Strike price, expiration date, everything, preferably with time, and we buy a random play in the morning, and we see the performance. So it's been doing pretty good, Chad, but you can see here since pretty much the beginning of the March, it's been declining, but you also see how the one trade a week strategy keeps you from getting clapped. So shout out to Chad, baby. But right off the bat, we survived last week, and there is going to be a lot more inflation data, literally the CPI this week. But if you remember what happened last week, you had everything with what Yellen said at the beginning of the week, then her press conference, and then do not forget the very surprising jobs report on Friday, and that is going to be the key here. So you are going to get the CPI this week, and depending on how that plays out, if we see a large surprise that's just as surprising as the jobs report, then the market is going to react, and even then, depending on the number that comes out, the market may react anyway. So here's the inflation data, and this is what makes this week's CPI so important. Again, kind of like last week, there's keys that we're watching for, but if you bring it up to the 1 year, you can see last month, again, it's about 30 days trailing, you see a big rise in inflation. Now, if I'll pull this out on the 25-year chart, you can see here, this is pretty much breaking out of a certain range, and depending on where it goes here, this could put us as high as levels as 2011, and now that is the point. Most economists are expecting a print of about 3.6%, which is well above the 2% from the Fed, and that would be two consecutive months of actually increasing inflation. So if that beats the high expectation or not, and 3.6 brings you back to a level as high as 2011, if there is anything that surprises, it is going to be an interesting situation considering how important inflation has been and with the data that we've been seeing last week. So watch out for that. That is what we're going to be watching. We want to see if it's a surprise or not. But at the same time now, you are going to get a lot of other data points. You're going to get retail sales, consumer confidence, and then the business inventories. Those are the three most important that I think, but you're also going to get a lot more. However, when you look at retail sales, the reopening trade, I think that is going to be very, very important this week. So however that plays out, it will be a very, very important key. Now, as far as the earnings are concerned, they're pretty much wrapping up, but you are still going to get some names here and there. So Chad, post them below, baby. But I'm pretty confident now that you're not going to get too many moves. You might see moves like Fastly last week where there could be some 15, 20% moves, but these aren't the real big companies, so it wouldn't disturb too much. So you could watch out for those. We could still probably make plays, but again, you've seen the power of the continuations. But the main thing I'm confident in right now, it's not that earnings is going to move the market, but that the real next move in the market here is going to come from policy and how the market responds to pricing that in. We did close at all-time highs, if you see the daily here, so this puts you at an interesting level, but the momentum has been a little flip-flop this last couple weeks with everything that happened, and then even with what we're seeing in crypto. But like I told you guys last week, it's already May here, so depending on the policy shifts or what we have to look ahead for, investors are going to start pricing into 2022 again, especially after we're finishing up this early earnings season right here. So I'm going to be keeping a watch on all the news and any policy updates. We have little things here and there to look out for, but the pace over the last 5 weeks now has increased, and I think this is really where you are going to get a market move. So watch out for that. And then finally, it's going to still be a busy week on the economic side. So if you do see any surprises, just make sure you watch out for that. Again, I showed you the main ones to watch out for, but who knows at this point. But the real key is going to be finding momentum, and that's why I want to look at some of the value stocks reopening trade, but especially commodities, because I'm expecting a pretty big move or more stability out of value like we saw last week, or at least the Dow, the manufacturing, industrial versus the growth. So we want to watch out for that, see how that plays. We'll see where the NASDAQ is. There is some key earnings for some of those hype stocks like Palantir and Workhorse, so we'll see what happens. But the key from tomorrow is really going to be seeing what trend does the market take, or does it really continue the trend from last week. So I hope you're ready, but that is pretty much it. So let us get into the plays. So right off the bat, I got three different stocks that I'm looking at. One's a real stock, but the other two is just more sectors and industries this week, and it is all dependent on that momentum. So I'm really going to be watching out for that tomorrow. But the first one, JWN Nordstrom's, I like it that it's a value stock. It's retail. You're going to get retail numbers. And if you look at their daily chart, I brought it up last week, they have just been holding up. So I really, really like where it's standing right now. And you got that buyout rumor from last week. Again, we've heard that over the years. I think it has a little bit more weight than some of those Amazon rumors last week. But overall, even without the rumor, I think if value and retail does good, they could be decent. So we're still holding that play. Got exposure. One of the contracts went down. The other one's held, but there's still a spread. So you just got to be careful, again, out of the money or anything like that. But that is going to be the first play. The second play I want to watch is going to be United Steel and XOM. But hopefully you get the point here. It's watching commodities right now. And really, I'm seeing it kind of like the Bitcoin altcoin situation. And I talked about this a few months ago. You saw oil go up. You've seen a lot of these commodity prices go up. That was the reflation trade. That was going from a depressed price back to normal. A balloon was dead. It got reinflated. But now, if it keeps going at an aggressive pace higher from here, that's where you start to just get a whole new level of growth out of there. So it reminds me of Bitcoin and the altcoins at these highs right now, because it's either going to get clapped and they're going to chill out, or if it does go crazy, it will actually go crazy here. So I want to watch these commodities. I want to watch energy again, any basic materials. They have been killing it right now, and that is part of that value manufacturing back to open trade all in general, just more economic activity versus growth services, anything of that. So I like that play. I like this sector, but the problem is going to be now it's very hard to play because of the premiums. I may want to look for shares, and I just want to see too if we still get that momentum and confirmation that hey, this is more than just a reflation trade. I think these will be very, very good. So keep your eye on that one and be a little bit careful. And then finally, this one, they're kind of related, not really, but Zoom and BABA. I want to watch just the China stocks and the work from home trade. There is a lot of other China stocks like JD, Baidu, but you got some of those hints last week. I think even if you look at the daily on BABA, that thing is very, very clapped. But sadly, the premiums have not really adjusted. You could get premiums cheaper here than when you bought them here at any other point. So you see here, though, over the last year, BABA has just really stayed flat and held this position. So if you do get any policy, and again, we got some hints of that last week, that will probably not be the best. And I want to see how that plays out. And then Zoom, brought this one up last week, kind of got caught up with it and everything else, but those premiums are slightly creeping up. Again, a lot of piggy bank levels on some of these growth stocks, so that is going to be key, but watch them. I do have plays on both Zoom and BABA, so if anything, I've been using them as place markers. I might be able to double dip on those, so we'll see what happens, but those are going to be the main plays as far as everything else. I want to watch Walgreens. Again, all of the first plays I got up here, it's going to be X, United Steel, any of these value stocks, commodities. Again, not necessarily saying that this is a value rotation, but it is just simply continuing that momentum that a lot of these companies have already had, and you've seen how they perform there. So I do think oil is still susceptible, and I have those puts. I'm going to be holding them. That's why it's not really like I'd want to chase oil on the way up, but I do like United Steel a little bit better, more of a basic material than energy. So I'm sure some of you are like, wait a minute, I thought we had XOM puts. Just in general, again, this was related to the news and all that, but I do want to watch them and see how they play out, because it will give us an idea of how the market is going to play. So watch them. Watch Workhorse. We got that play last week, ended up being a dud, didn't really do much, but we are going to get their earnings tomorrow morning, I believe, so we'll see how that one plays out. Palantir is going to be Tuesday morning, and I think this one's at a very key piggy bank level, so we'll see how that one plays out, but watch them. Watch Roblox. They have earnings on May 10th, tomorrow, I believe, after hours, so depending on how that plays, it will be key. Remember, we got our average down of 100 shares. Depending on the earnings, we will see if we will continue to build out our position or not, but I think that one's going to be exciting. Then even UMC, they got clapped because of Arquite. They are going to to report this week as well. I think they've gotten really cheap and we've burned enough time where it's like, I can't do anything but average down on it. I think it's a really good value here. So may get a little bit before the earnings, may get a little bit after. However, we did talk about it a lot on stream. They have an interesting earnings coming up here, considering I think a lot of the market is priced in Arquite, but they may not suffer the same fate. So we'll see how that one plays out. Watch them. Watch AMD. I want to see if the chip makers do come up and if there is anything with the commodity or manufacturing trade, or if there's just positive news in general. Again, they had good earnings. They were doing good. So if you do see growth pick up, at least you know where to look. So watch out for them. Again, Nordstrom's, like we said, and here's the chart. You can see what I'm talking about. They got that rumor the other day, but overall, they've just held up barely above their 2021 price. And then if you come here, it actually brings them right at their 2020 level. So this is pretty much the epitome of the value trade when you really see how a lot of the other ones have played, but compare it to other retail. But we've seen stuff like Gap, which has gone past that 2020 level and then ended up taking off. But Gap kind of did the same thing, but they did not have the buyout rumor and they had Kanye. So watch out for them. Watch Fastly. I'm still in this play. I want to see if it continues. That play did chill out a little bit. They ended up dropping through the day, but now the contract's back at break even since it's like $5 out of the money and it's going to expire next week. So we'll see how that plays. Watch Novak. They're going to have earnings and you saw a lot of the vaccine stocks last week. I want to see if you see that trend again, but this one might be very, very interesting, at least if you even want to trade. It has a big range, but be very careful with the premiums. And then BABA, like we said, and now finally to TLT in the dollar. Bonds have been actually relatively chill here. We haven't been getting too much. I'm not too worried about them. The key is literally going to be the dollar here. And now you see last week it's dropping. You're going to get inflation numbers now. And if anything, by seeing the dollar make this big move and then TLT leveling out, this is something we've talked about. Remember this big move here, pretty much the dollar's now catching up to it now that bonds have stabilized. So I think once the dollar kind of levels out, maybe either towards this bottom here, it's either going to keep going down, but we're probably going to get a new level on the dollar depending on the data, or it might take even a month. And that will give us more insight. And there is other stuff to watch, like even the crypto and just the overall valuations of the market. But if anything, I think the dollar is the main key, unless there is a surpriser with bonds. But for the most part, if anything is going to move both of those, I know it's going to be policy. So I hope you're ready. But that is your watch list, ladies and gentlemen. Make sure hydrate, healthy, ready to go. Make sure you post your watch list. Make sure we see you there in the morning. I need the armor on. I need the helmet shining. Don't forget what's yours is yours and you're being prepared, baby. But the cold loves you. I love you. I'm going to see you in the morning. Let's go.